Hi, HR interviews are one of the compulsory rounds for every kind of job. Normally, it takes years to analyze one single person. But still, why HR interview rounds are conducted? Because it is just to have a small gist on what you are. How will you work in their company and how you behave when you are placed in a typical corporate lifestyle? Or maybe a setup called as private or a government or a semi-government. Your working attitude and everything will be just noted and highlighted, but not remarked, just by one interview. Mostly these interviews are kept to know how good you are in expressing and also how creatively you think to handle situations. If it's a government HR interview or let's say a private HR interview round, then make sure that you have at least know about the famous person related to that organization. People who are already, you know, working, they have a work experience and they can tell you something about that particular company to which you are going for an interview. Better you are prepared in advance. It will augur well for you all. And try to know more about the maybe the state, the economic status and everything that is related to that particular state, that particular company, its culture and everything about it. As much as you know, the more confident you walk into an interview process. That is what is most important. So here we are going to give you a small hint on how all the common types of questions you face and the way to answer them. We are not going to give you the exact answer. Most important is what we are trying to look at is the temperament and the attitude of how to approach HR questionnaires. Some frames on what you have to answer accordingly, which may be helpful to you in a longer run. Be it the job you're taking for the first time or maybe you're taking for the second or the third, nth number of job, how to approach, how to build that kind of a temperament and attitude is what we are going to talk about in this particular shoot. So what you should not miss is one of the best opportunities you are facing that point of time. There are many differences in HR rounds. Some of them could be like various types of interviews that you attend. Informational interview, just for the information, whether you are good, bad, ugly on the surface. Telephonic round, which is a typical round which many of you must have faced. One-to-one interview, which is called as face-to-face. One-to-many interview. Many-to-one also, there is a panel, you know, sits across and there's one single interview. IAS interviews are typically like that. Behavioral interview to see how you behave. Stress interviews. Video conference interview, which is going to be a mainstay here because now the pandemic has taken a toll and the entire scene from offline to online has shown its domino effect. So there will be a lot of changes which you need to customize yourself and maybe develop yourself with this video conference interview. Situational interviews are also one of types. So here we are going to give you a combination of all the above formats in this particular shoot where all these questions are most commonly you come across. So the most common questions that you normally come across in a typical interview HR setup, we are going to give you an orientation of it. Things are normally asked from what you say. So you need to choose your word, you need to be conscious of what you are saying and remember also, because many a times you just say with a flow and you forget what you've spoken, that actually gets highlighted or get re-exposed and you come across with the same question getting rephrased and you need to show the consistency behind. So that is where you need to be confident about. And do not hesitate to come back to the same word and show what kind of consistency you have shown. Let us consider every question now. There will be 52 questions coming your way and you need to crisply, you know, prepare. Try and understand the temperament, the attitude, the approaches. We are seeing only the approaches of how to answer a typical HR questionnaire. You need to learn only the approaches and phrase your own answer taking a clue from what we are explaining to you, right? So build your psyche, the right psyche to crack any interview, HR interview for that matter. Tell me something about yourself. I had a fantastic student who happened to answer the same question very nicely. And he's coming from a village. So his name is Naveen. Naveen tried and approached this, answering it very beautifully. Really. So I'm quoting Naveen here. He says, "My name is Naveen Kumar. I have completed my undergraduation from GNTU with distinction. My father is a farmer and my mother is a homemaker. My siblings work for IT industries and have their own business. My interest is to become a software engineer and can exhibit all that education which I have been learning from all these years. Other than this, I play cricket. I'm a good filmmaker too." Now, if you see how Naveen has answered, he has beautifully explained everything and in a flow. He started with his name, his family history, his interest, his education and career objective, which goes in a flow which explains that Naveen is kind of a sorted guy. He knows about himself, he knows about what he is doing consciously, and I think that's a good flow. So what you need to understand is you can have your name followed by your native, followed by your family history, followed by your interest, and the last thing that you should, you know, finish off this introduction with the career objective. I'm sure how you are answering, what you are answering, based on this you will have the second question coming. And the second question here is how many siblings you have and what they are doing. So Naveen was able to answer it that he has two elder brothers. One is working with the IT company and the second is having his own business. That's coming out from the first question, whatever answers that you quote in the question number one. Questions to be followed next. Number two was out of the answer coming in from the first question itself about siblings. So Naveen was able to answer it very, very nicely. Do you have any plans for studying further? Out of a blue, you can get a surprise also, and this question is for a surprise, right? Do you have plans to study more? Have you put a full stop to your study? It can be asked in any way. You need to really answer it putting your mind. Never say that you have put a full stop to your study. Always say yes. And how Naveen has answered this: yes, I'm interested in doing my MBA and doing it in finance, but I want to do it maybe after 2 or 3 years, because I wanted to have a working experience in a growing organization like yours. So something which is logically expected, I think Naveen was able to do that, which you all should also learn and do it nicely. Since Naveen answered the first question by saying that he likes to play cricket, he has an interest to play cricket. So the next question number four is coming based on his interest, which is playing cricket. What do you like most in cricket and why? That they ask such question to know about your explanation that you give for your answers, by which the candidate's way of looking into things can be judged. See how Naveen is answering is, I like Sachin Tendulkar and Yuvraj Singh in cricket. I like the way Sachin keeps, you know, holding his place, playing a role of a sheet anchor in the game. And when it's important for a team to be there, I think he stands up for the team and he ensures that there is no fall of wickets more. And Yuvraj, who's also called as UV as nickname, with the way he handled things, you know, when he comes as fourth down, and when the team needs more runs in a shorter span, less ball, he scores more. So what a way to answer. I think you need to understand the approach of how Naveen has answered, right? Why everyone is saying it is so important to crack an HR interview? Why? Because even if you get good marks in written test, you need to perform well in an interview. Also, then only you will get the job. Nowadays, the competition is growing rapidly. So they are eliminating the candidates while conducting the interviews. And it is so rapid fire that once if you are exposed to any kind of question, not answering them in a proper way, I think they easily gauge this and you are shown the exit door.